Chiara Manzini, and I'm an assistant professor at the George Washington University, and you're in my office. We work on a variety of disorders that affect brain development, ranging from autism, intellectual disability, and all the way to brain malformations, which are very severe disruptions in the way the brain forms in babies. I grew up in a small town in Italy. My dad was the town doctor. He really wanted me to be a physician. I really didn't want to be a physician because I was always interested in biology since when I was a little kid. When I was 12, I read a book about molecular biology, and I had always been interested in science, but I clearly remember like reading about DNA and recombinant proteins and being just like, oh my God, this is the coolest thing ever. And I've pretty much had a single focus ever since. So I'm interested in how the brain forms, and during the development of a baby, if something goes wrong, I want to figure out how that can lead to disease that affects either the cognitive abilities, so the capacity for learning, and social interactions. At the beginning of the week, I'll talk to the people in the lab, and we'll talk about plans for the week, what they want to do, so I can have meetings with people in the lab. There will be, right now I'm writing grants because we're nearing the deadlines, so most of what I do is like write grant proposals, we'll write papers. For me, it's really the excitement to be able to just go back to a family and say, this is what's wrong with your kid, which I think is really important, and at least you give them an answer on what is going on in the disease. Because you can't do science in a box, you actually have to talk to a lot of people, you have to constantly come up with ideas. And what I find really fascinating is actually the more diverse the background, the more diverse the expertise that a person has, the better it is to talk to them about research, because they'll come up with ideas that you wouldn't have thought about. And hopefully in the long term, what we really want to do is to be able to understand what these genes do and to identify targets for therapies so that we could develop approaches to treat or cure the diseases we work on. I've had a lot of friends who are exceptional scientists that don't do well in standardized tests. And so I think you should never forget your passion for science, especially if you're not a traditional learner. And so I think that is really important, because you have to work really, really hard, but also you have to figure out your way of like getting through the hurdles of schooling sometimes. And so it's really important for kids to know that it doesn't matter if you have a learning disability or a reading disability, you can still be incredibly creative, and you can use your brain to do amazing things. So.